Christmas from the Long Defeat blog. Hope you're all having a lovely day and you've gotten the gifts that you want, that you asked for from Father Christmas, or indeed from anyone else. Just a really short video and post here from the Long Defeat blog. Just something maybe you can watch whilst you, or listen to, in a break from your Christmas reveling. Maybe in a 5-minute tea break or whatever. Maybe in the evening after you've all popped yourself silly. But anyway, this is a... I'm going to read out a poem by GA Studdert Kennedy, who was a chaplain in the First World War. Unfortunately, many people don't really know about him and have not read about him, but he predominantly meditated on the incarnation, on God becoming man, which is exactly what we celebrate this Christmas. So I want to read a poem from his collection of poems called The Unutterable Beauty, which you can buy online, and I think you can actually find the whole collection online too. I'll have the lyrics to this particular poem down below. It's called If Jesus Never Lived, and it concerns the existence of Christ, and it sort of it thinks about what would it be the case if Jesus never lived, what sort of state would humanity be in and we be in. But it also talks about something really interesting, that the incarnation of Christ makes all things, it makes fairy tales true. It brings wonder into the world. And if Jesus didn't live, then fairy tales are just fairy tales to be left behind on the nursery floor. But in reality, Jesus did live, and God did become man. And as such, wonder is in our reach. So anyway, I'm going to read this out and see what you think. Try and follow along. I know it's not always easy to follow along with poetry. I am certainly not a poetry expert, but I think this will really complement your Christmas celebrations. So, with no further ado, let's continue. So, this is called If Jesus Never Lived. Suppose it is not true, and Jesus never lived, but only grew, like Aphrodite, from the foam of fancy, from the sea of pure imagining that frets within the soul eternally. Suppose the Word was not made flesh, but just another dream which dwelt amongst us only as a gleam of glory from the land where sand is gold, and golden sand shines bright beside the sapphire sea, where up is down, and down is up, and mortals mount on wings to sup from golden goblets with young stars, the nectar of eternity, where trees have souls and lilies arms to fold us in, and charms to soothe our sorrows into peace, where cease and sink to silence of content the sad complainings man has sent to heaven's high throne, all down the years, where bitter tears are turned to diamonds for the crown of God. Suppose he never trod this earth, nor saw the sun, nor looked up to the skies, that sinless one, all spotless clean, untainted by man's curse, the might have been, the ghost of good undone. Suppose the gospel story lies, what then, why then, there are no fairies anymore for men, the shore of fairyland is dry, unlapped by any sea, all fancies die if Jesus never lived, for living fancies need to be the symbols of a truth. He is the door by which we enter into Wonderland, by Christ's strong sooth set free from sin. Poor Cinderella weds her prince, as we long since were taught and may believe. For God is found of those who seek, exalts the humble and the meek, and puts the mighty from their seats in Christ. Her trust, if Jesus never lived, is still unkept. By those dead ashes where she wept for paradise, she weeps on still and moans upon her fate. The pumpkins still are pumpkins, and the mice still mice. Still by the cold and empty grate, she sits in rags and tears through all the years, the empty years. No fairy comes, nor ever will, if Jesus never lived. In Christ's pure light, fair snowy white can lift the coffin lid and leave her tomb and vanquish all the gloom of death. because he lives and gives to Sleeping Beauty one long kiss. She opens her blue eyes and wakes, forsakes her sleep and shines forever, beautiful in bliss. There is no chance of childhood but for this one child of God who knew that childhood's sweetest dreams come true and was their truth. Lord Jesus, live for me. Open my eyes to see thy face. So by thy grace shall all the world be peopled by bright forms. The wind of many voices in its storms shall speak of giant powers. The many-colored flowers shall hold their lips up for a kiss. Still in the deep shall mermaids sleep, and dryads from the oak tree stretch white hands, while through the leaves small faces peep, and laugh in elfin revelry, binding with silken bands my spirit to the glades. So shall my soul swing free of this small world, and dance with daffodilly maids amid the bluebells in the sun. Oh, live for me, thou sinless one, cleanse thou for me the earth and sea, sweep all the clouds from off the sky, for fancies never, never die if Jesus lives.